Hello students, how you all? Hope all of you are doing well. Actually, all of us know we are suffered with COVID-19, so that's why we are staying at home. All over the world there is lockdown, but in India it has been increased till 3rd May. During that we are doing our best effort to make you understand with the online videos. Hope all of you are watching also. If you are having any doubt during this online video session, then please drop your doubt into the comment box section that I can understand what you want or what you are not able to understand and which type of concept you wanted. So in the previous video of class 8 science, chapter number 3, synthetic fibers and plastic, I had explained about many of the synthetic fibers like nylon, rayon, acrylic, their properties, their uses. I have asked you some questions also related to that. Today we are going to just do the comparison of natural fabrics and synthetic fabric. We actually teach to the students that we should not do comparison between an intelligent and a poor student, but when the differentiation question comes, that time this is a very important thing, that when we are doing the comparisons of natural fabrics and synthetic fabrics. First of all, what are the natural fabrics? A fabric which is obtained from plants and animals is called natural fabrics, right? And a fabric which is obtained in chemical industries or just with the help of chemicals it is being obtained, so you can say that it is a synthetic fiber. So do you have any doubt during this natural fiber and synthetic fiber? If you have any doubt, then you can ask me that what is natural fiber or synthetic fiber. So during that, if you have seen all the properties of the natural fiber and synthetic fiber, here I have written also some of the properties. You can just go through this and after that I'll explain you in the detail. If you want to copy, then you can copy in the notebook also. As I have written on the board, you can see synthetic fibers have many advantages. They are durable, they are inexpensive and wrinkle resistant. They are stronger and more elastic than the natural fabrics because they are made up of long fabrics. They are also easy to maintain and dye and do not bleed colors. First of all, in the natural fiber and synthetic fiber, the main difference I had informed you in the earlier only, that natural fibers are very short and synthetic fibers are very long. So in the natural fibers, this is one demerit, that they are obtained in a very short form, and in synthetic fiber it can be obtained in the long form. Second thing, as here it is written also, the advantages of the advantages means they are good qualities, like they are very durable, they especially being observed in the maximum times, 2 years, 3 years, 4 years, 5 years, and many more years they are still being obtained. Second question, and second point is they are inexpensive. Natural fibers, to gain natural fibers we have to give a lot of money, but it is cheap in rate in comparison to natural fiber. It is more elastic, it can be spread many more. Wrinkle resistant, knowledge of iron, if you are doing the in the iron form, what happens in the cotton clothes, if you are doing an iron. Suppose this is the cotton cloth, not suppose, this is the real cotton clothes. So if this is a cotton shirt, if I put a crease on it, and if I again put on the another side, so I will get wrinkles. But if we talk about the synthetic fibers, they are wrinkle resistant. They do not worry about the wrinkles. Next one is they are natural fibers because they are not made up of sonu. So these are the properties. Now, however, most of the synthetic fibers are less absorbent than natural fibers. Definitely, synthetic fibers, they are less absorbent. They are not absorbing more and more water. But if we talk about the natural fibers, they absorb sweat also. They absorb more water also. Okay. Next one, in contrast, natural fibers like cotton absorb sweat quickly and very comfortable to wear in the hot weather. Most synthetic fibers are also flammable and melt easily. Therefore, they need to be ironed carefully. That is why they should not wear synthetic clothes in the kitchen or while sitting in the firewood. If we talk about the summer season, then in the summer season, natural fiber is best. Natural fiber means cotton, especially cotton clothes. When we wear cotton clothes during the summer season, they absorb the sweat and gives us cooling, right? But if we talk about the synthetic, any of the synthetic which are especially not good in summer season. In summer season, if we are wearing synthetic clothes, they can't absorb sweat. They gives you the patches on your shirts, you will see, especially some of the clothes which you are wearing full day, you are holding bags, and after coming home, you will see the patches on your shirts. That patches are just forming scrap on your shirt, that is due to the less absorbent. If we wear a cotton shirt, in the cotton shirt they absorb the sweat and they give us cooling. Okay, so sometimes natural fibers are more advantageous than the synthetic fiber, but if we talk about the inexpensive and cheaper than the time, synthetic fiber is good. But we have to understand which type of shirt should be wearing which month, right? So if you are wearing any synthetic clothes like nylon or polyester and you are working in a kitchen, that time you must be careful, because the synthetic fibers catch fire easily. So that time you have to be very and very careful. Okay, natural fibers also have disadvantages. Yes, not only synthetic fiber have disadvantages. If I have talked about they are catching fire, then natural fibers also have disadvantages. They are easily attacked by the insect. They shrink and lose the shape. They do not have strong and durable as synthetic fibers. Fibers like wool and silk are generally not washed in a washing machine. They are used only dry clean. Yes, many more disadvantages do natural fibers. You can see here, so many wrinkles I have got on this cotton shirt. Similarly, if we talk about the silk can't be washed in a washing machine. Then you will see some of the clothes is written there, dry wash should be there, and it should not be kept in outside because they can lose the color also, they can lose many things. So that's why we should remember, whenever we are talking about the advantages, then we should see the quality. When we talk about the disadvantages, then which type of demerit that clothes have. Not only we have to compare both the things, natural fabrics and synthetic fabrics, their qualities and disadvantages, disqualities, both the things. Natural fibers also have quality, synthetic fiber also have quality. Natural fiber also have disadvantages, synthetic fiber also have disadvantages. Now question is, there is one experiment. In this experiment, the aim is to test different fabrics, fiber for water absorbing capacity, reaction on heating, effect on flame. So you can see here, this is your aim is to test different fabrics and fibers for water absorbing capacity, reaction on heating, effect of flame, like thermal conductivity, electrical conductivity and tensile strength. What are the materials required? The material requires a sample of the same size of the different fabrics, natural and synthetic, a long thread from each fabric, beakers, weighing balance, Bunsen burner, china dish, tongs, stand, pan, weights, test circuit consisting of cell bulb and wires. Water absorbing capacity. See here, you can see this. You can take a screenshot of this page, as you can take a screenshot after then. See, to take in the two part. First, second part is this, right? After then, first part is this. So as you have taken a screenshot. Now let me explain you about these all the things. First of all, in the demonstrations, as I have told you, we have to just test the different fabrics and fibers for water absorbing capacity. Means which type of clothes absorb more and more water. Which type of clothes absorb more and more water. So after getting a knowledge of absorbing more and more water, now we will move towards that water absorbing capacity. What is the formula of water absorbing capacity? First of all, we have to take a sample. After then, weigh the sample on a laboratory weighing balance. Place each sample in a beaker of water till it fully wetted and take it out, allowing excess water to drip back into the beaker. Weigh each sample again, determine the amount of water absorbed, calculate the percentage absorption as follows. Means, first of all, what we have to do, we have to take different types of fabrics. As we are taking different like cotton, synthetic, in the rayon, nylon, plastic, polyester, whatever the fabrics we have taken, after taking the fabrics, each and every fabrics we have to put it deep inside the water. First, before dipping inside the water, we have to weigh what are the weights of these natural fibers, what are the weights of these synthetic fibers. After that, we have to write in column. After dipping into the water, again take out, and that time again measure into the weighing balance, we will get the weight of absorbed clothes. So now the formula will be percentage absorption, final weight of the simple sample minus initial weight upon initial weight into 100. Means percentage absorption is equal to final weight minus initial weight upon initial weight into 100. See, so this is the percentage absorption formula. As we have written the percentage absorption formula, so we will what do? We'll have to just take the sample, first take the initial weight, after absorbing take the final weight, after taking the final weight, now we are taking out the percentage of absorption. You can see here formula is written, absorption is equal to final weight minus initial weight by initial weight into the 100, right? Now as you have taken the formula, you have done each and every clothes experiment. Now reaction on heating. Place each sample in a china dish and heat it over a flame. Observe which fabric melts. Means all the fabrics are wet. Now you have to flame it and you have to check that which fabrics are burning or which fabrics are melting. Effect of the flame. Bring each of the sample near the flame using a pair of tongs. Observe which fabric catch fire, note the nature of the flame, the smell produced of the nature, combustion and products. Means as we are bringing nearby the fire, which type of samples is catching fire, which type of smell they are producing, and after them, which products they are forming. Thermal conductivity, take one beaker and wrap each one tightly with the sample fabric. Place a thermometer in each beaker. Pour a temperature of water in each beaker after 15 minutes. Means what we have to do, we have to wrap the sample very tightly and then we have to put a thermometer into the beaker. We have to just check the temperature till the 15 minutes we have to keep inside the water, and after then we have to observe. Electrical conductivity, we have to pass electricity on that sample if they are passing or not. Tensile strength, material of the amount of force required to pull a point during the breaks. Have the high tensile strength, means just see about the elasticity, the fabric has to stand in a tight pan to free and the thread. Place weight on the pan till the thread breaks and note down which thread can be most weight. Remember dear students, after getting all this information about these fabrics, what we have to do, we have to understand about that which fabric is best. Synthetic materials except rayon do not absorb much water. Rayon absorb much and more water. Synthetic fibers melt when heated and do not leave ash behind when burnt. The exception is rayon, which burns like cotton and leaves ash behind. Insulating properties vary depending on the fabric. Most natural and synthetic fibers do not conduct electricity, as exception is zari, which is made from fiber covered with metal. Most synthetic fibers have higher tensile strength than natural fibers, as exception is silk, which is obtained as long, strong filament. So these were the properties of natural and synthetic fibers. How to understand which fabric is best if we take care about the natural fibers or synthetic fiber. That time we understood, yes, natural fiber is this type and synthetic fiber is of this type. So after getting all this knowledge about these fibers, we should understand that how to test the fibers. If you don't have these fibers, then you can go nearby your tailor shop. They will give you some of the clothes. After that, you can do these things and you can do the checkup of which fiber is best and which fiber has this all quality. That's all for today. Thanks for watching. Don't forget to like and subscribe. Share this video with your friends so your friends can also take knowledge. If you are having any type of doubt, please drop a doubt into the comment box section. Thanks for today. Thanks for watching. Thank you. Stay home. Stay safe.